Buzzing Bees. I am Jenny.
I'm Debbie and I'm Steve.
Today, I'm going to take you to a quick home tour about how to have a basic setup at home for your child within your budget. The setup is really helpful if you're planning to homeschool your child. As some of you may be thinking for this year, especially due to COVID reason, and even if a child is going to school, they spend most of the time at home. So it's really important to create a child-friendly environment for them. Trust me, it's extremely helpful as most of the learning takes place at home and it also keeps them away from screen. Before I dive into some detail, let's have a glimpse of a setup first. This is how I have arranged. Arrangement is very important. If it's not properly arranged, then your child will never pick up things as they find it cluttered. I like the low shelf for the kids so they can have access to things. And everything I have kept in a different basket or tray, as you can see, so a child starts to learn everything has a rightful place. So this is my basic setup where Debbie's most of the learning takes place. It's perfect for toddlers and up to 6 years of age where they can explore and learn. You can keep some age-appropriate toys and books according to your child's age and interest. Now, I will talk about how to organize this arrangement. If you have a 2 or 3 rack shelf, you can use that for arrangement, or you can take something like this from your old furniture. And these 2 are handmade toys, which you would have seen in my previous videos. And if not, I recommend you to watch and prepare one for your child. In my upcoming videos, you will find more different learning DIY toys and activities to learn different concept and topic. I found alphabet puzzle very useful as she's learning sounds of each letter, which will help her further to read. These wooden letters can be used variously in different activities. This is a balancing toy. It's good to have as kids will understand the concept of balance. These are shape puzzle and shape sorting toys. Now you must have some type of blocks in your shelf. Mine is wooden with different shapes and colors. It teaches kids early math and engineering skills through hands-on learning. It really enhances their creativity. I keep rotating these toys once in 10 days depending on the interest of learning and to keep things new and fresh. This blackboard which you see is not for me to teach A, B, C, D or 1, 2, 3. It's for her to scribble or draw what she likes. Now this mat which you're seeing, she picks a mat when she wants to sit and once she finishes, she folds and keeps it back at its place. Initially, your child may not arrange or put their toys back. It's okay. Never force a child. It will take some time for them to learn. But slowly when they see you doing, they will imitate you. That's how they learn. Moving to next, I have utilized my old shelf to keep her items. This is her artwork. Recently, she did activity P for Pim Pom and N for newspaper. Now, this top shelf is not accessible to her. I keep items which I can give at the time of certain activity or when she asks me to do painting, stamp, craft, etc., etc. And these are some books for my reference. This is a tiny shelf with drawers as kids always get fascinated with things like this. And they always have some things to store like stationery items, etc. Now in this lower shelf, there is mostly role-playing items or toys. As at this age, kids really like to play with train set, kitchen set, doctor set. So you can keep tool set or dollhouse. I prefer wood, but some items are not accessible in wood. So make sure if you're buying by branded plastic toys, which are BPA free. I recently changed dollhouse setup she was bored and replaced it with a doctor set. She keeps making her own play with her favorite peppers. Make sure to keep one based on your child interest. Even in this, you keep rotating and keep rotating at time. Don't keep more than two or three. Now here is Debbie's most exciting section. She loves books. I have arranged in a way so it's easy to identify for me, as from here I take few books and keep it separately, as you've seen. I keep bedtime storybooks separately, which is placed near the bed. Here is another exciting place to talk about. It's always important to have a world map where your child can easily see. Hang world map at and other interesting artwork at eye level. Few months back, she was interested in this, and now again she has shown interest to know about different countries, learning about continent in a fun way. I will share separate video on how to make this type of learning interesting. It's good to have a table and chair. If you don't have, see if you can get one or make one. This table which you see is made of waste plywood and painted by us. Make sure your child table is always empty, so when they pick up something, they can concentrate easily. Next to the table, I have arranged her colors, Play-Doh, and some coloring book, so it's easy for her to do at the table. You can arrange one or two musical instruments depending on your child's interest. It's good if you have a separate space in the corner to keep. I picked this type of globe as it's easy for her to understand at this age, as she can mark and reuse again. Now these books I have taken from bookshelf and I keep changing it every week. You can add books based on your child interest at that stage. Like when she shows interest in dinosaur, I try to keep something related to that in my shelf. I try to keep coloring books based on the books I placed here to make learning more interesting for her. I also try doing some activities related to the books, which again you will see in some of my videos further. Like recently I did skeleton activity. I couldn't find insect book with good pictures, so I made some flashcards using these pictures. While choosing animal or bird book, try to get books which has real pictures. Down is some activity books, including a sticker book, a drawing book which she uses for painting. While choosing writing book, go for books which has tracing along with some other fun activities at the same page. So your kid will be interested in tracing letters, numbers. From few months, she herself started writing few numbers and letters. I don't even have to teach her. I help her only when she asks my help. Children are capable of learning by themselves. We just have to provide an environment and make it child-centered so they are free to learn at their own pace. So this was my setup. Hope you liked it. Apart from this, Debbie spends most of her time in doing physical activities and she loves doing household chores. So in my upcoming videos, I will share with you in detail about some practical life skills which are very important for a child's development at this age, and also about how you can make some physical activity interesting for your child. If you have any questions or doubt related to this, feel free to reach out to me. Thank you for watching. If you like my video, do subscribe and share. Bye.